Good morning. Myself, Dr. B. Sarita, Associate Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. The course name is Rural Water Supply and On-Site Sanitation System. And the topic which I am going to discuss is Need for Water Treatment. In Need for Water Treatment, we are going to see the following topics like water supply systems, sources of water, water quality categories, water quality parameters, water quality issues, and need for water treatment. Under water supply systems, we are going to see the definition for water supply system. Water supply system is the infrastructure for various works like collection, transmission, treatment, storage, and distribution of water for homes, commercial establishments, industry, and irrigation, as well as for public needs and also for firefighting and street flushing. So, provision of potable water is more significant for the public use. So we have to go for the treatment of the water before distributing the water to the public. So the public, the users, they depend on water for various purposes like drinking, cooking, washing, carrying away waste, and other domestic needs. So this water supply system should meet all these requirements, mainly for public, commercial, and industrial activities. In all the cases, the water must fulfill both the quality and also the quantity requirements. So the quality means the physical, chemical, biological characteristics of the water should be analyzed whether it satisfies the water quality standards before distributing the treated water to the public. And quantity of the water, the selected source of water should supply water continuously so that without any a demand, the water can be continuously supplied to the public. The next topic is objectives of water supply system. So what are the various objectives? The first one is to supply safe and wholesome water to the users or consumers. The second objective is to supply water in sufficient quantities. And the third one is to supply water at convenient points and timings. Wherever it is required, we have to supply the water at particular time. And to supply water at reasonable or affordable cost to the users or consumers. So these are the various objectives of water supply system. And the primary objective of water treatment, that is water treatment process for the supply of water to the public, starts from collection of water from particular source and then subjecting the collected water to the treatment process, various treatment process. And after ensuring the quality of the water, for example, it should be free from unpleasant taste or odor. And also the treated water should not contain any pollutants which will be harmful to health. So this is the primary objective of the water treatment which comes under this water supply system. Coming to the sources of water. So water supply system means it starts with the first and foremost objective, that is selecting proper source of water. So there are various sources of water which are broadly classified into two categories. The first category is the surface sources such as ponds and lakes, then streams and rivers, storage reservoirs, and of course oceans. Generally, ocean water is not used for water supply. It is not selected as source for water supply at present. And coming to the subsurface sources or underground sources, we have springs, infiltration wells, and wells and tube wells. These are the two broad categories of sources of water. That is, the first one is surface sources, and the second category is subsurface sources. Otherwise, it is called as underground sources. Why we have to discuss about these sources mean, the first and foremost work that is taken under the water supply system is selecting appropriate source where the water is available continuously, and also the quality of the water should be somewhat good so that we can go for the treatment and we can supply the water to the public. So under water supply system, we have the following units of works. Under that, the first unit of work is called the collection works. The second one is the transmission works. And third one is the purification works. And the fourth one is distribution works. We can see the various units of works one by one. The first one called the collection works. So in collection works, these are meant for the development of surface water or groundwater resources. For major cities or where water requirement are large, water is collected from a surface source like a river or stream. And if the river is perennial, a direct intake structure can be built on the river bank. So if, however, a river is not a perennial, a dam is constructed across the river so that the water can be collected from that reservoir. So that is called the collection works. And coming to the next one, that is, the water is then drawn from the reservoir as per the needs, that is the stored water. So therefore, the collection works consists of storage work or diversion work and an intake structure. And the second unit of work is the transmission works. So the collection works may be far away from the city where water is to be supplied. So in that case, water is conveyed to the city through the transmission works. These work, that is the transmission work, form the connecting link between the collection works and the purification works, depending upon the topography of the area between the two sites. The transmission works may be in the form of conduits, canals, or aqueducts. And for simply gravity flow, canals are generally used. And the third unit of work is the purification work. So the water which is collected directly from the source may not be safe for drinking purpose because it may contain physical impurities, chemical impurities, and biological impurities. So the municipal water works must deliver to the consumer the water which is hygienically safe and palatable and economically satisfactory for its intended use. Because from the water, the water containing the pathogens, various diseases are caused, like cholera, typhoid, dysentery, etc., various waterborne disease. So the principal aim of the purification work, that is the third unit of work, is to purify the water, that is by undergoing various treatment process, like starting from screening, sedimentation, then sedimentation aided with coagulation, then filtration process, then disinfection, and at last it is stored and supplied to the public based on their demand. So this, the collective work, is called purification work. And the fourth unit of work is the distribution works. The treated and purified water is finally sent to the consumers through suitable distribution network. So in order, the water may flow in the water supply pipes under pressure. The pure water is normally stored in elevated service reservoir, and then it is supplied to the public. More than one reservoir may be needed in large systems. And by, we have various types of distribution networks. So proper distribution network is selected before supplying the treated water to the public. So these are the four units of works carried out under water supply system. Then we have the layout of the water supply systems. In layout of water supply system, we can see the various unit of works. So it is given clearly in this diagram. Here, the first unit of work, the collection work, the water is collected from the reservoir. That is the first unit of work, collection work. Then you have the pump, pump house, to pump the collected water to the next unit of work, that is the treatment process. So the water is conveyed or transmitted to the treatment plant through pipe, canals, or any channels. So the construction of pipe, canal, channels, etc., comes under the transmission works. So which is used to convey the water from the source where it is collected to the treatment plant. So the transmission work is the second unit of work under water supply system. And the third unit of work is a purification works, where you treat the water and where you have all the treatment units like screens, sedimentation tank, then aeration unit, then flocculation tank, coagulation tank, then clarifier, filters, sump house, and the overhead reservoir. And these are the various that is, in water treatment works, you can see various treatment units. The first one screen, then here it is given preliminary settling tank, that is primary sedimentation tank, then still well, aeration process, then coagulants added. After that, water is sent to the flocculation channel. And from the flocculation channel, water is sent to the clarifier, which is nothing but a sedimentation tank. And from that, water flows into the filter house, filtration process. Then if it is required, water is sent for disinfection process. Then it is stored in the sump. Then afterwards, it is pumped to a overhead reservoir before distributing the treated water to the public or the consumers. So through a proper distribution network, the treated water is supplied to the public. So the last unit of work under water supply system is distribution works. So here the water is distributed to the public by selecting appropriate distribution network. So this layout of water supply system clearly depicts the various unit of works carried out under this system. Next, we have the heading water quality. So what is water quality? Water quality indicates the physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of the water, and it is the measure of condition of water relative to the requirements of one or more biotic species or based on the human need. So the human need may vary. Suppose due to industrialization, urbanization, there is growth of industries. So agricultural activities are there. So then irrigation work, based on the need of water for particular purpose, the quality of water needed also varies. So drinking water purpose means we have to select certain parameters to check the water quality. Suppose in industries, if you are using, we have certain standards for the water quality to be used in industries. Industries also, we have various types. So in each and every industry, the water quality, the requirement of the water quality varies. So depending upon their requirement, their category, their standard, the water is treated mainly considering the physical, chemical, and biological characteristic to serve their need. And it is most frequently used by reference to a set of standards. So against which it is compared. That is, set of standards means, for example, if the water is to be supplied for drinking purpose, then the treated water, after selecting from the source, after treatment, the treated water should satisfy the drinking water standards. So standards are nothing but certain range of values having the various parameters like physical parameter, chemical and biological parameter of the water. So to that range or to that level given in the drinking water standards, the various water quality parameters, we have to compare after treating the water before supplying the water for drinking purpose. That is called the standards. The most common standards used to assess water quality related to health of ecosystem. So based on the health, the standards are designed or framed based on the health of the ecosystem, safety of human contact, and the drinking water. Now next we have water quality categories. Under this water quality, we categorize like human consumption, industrial use, and in the environment and for irrigation purpose. So human consumption, drinking water, even the bottled water may be expected to have some contaminants. So presence of this contaminants does not indicate that it poses some health risk. So even in that, we are having some contaminants. And industrial use, dissolved minerals may affect the suitability of water for a range of industrial and domestic purpose. And presence of ions of calcium and magnesium, it interferes with the hardness, that is the action of soap, and it forms hard sulfate and soft carbonate deposits mainly in water heaters or boilers. So the hard water which is used has to be softened to remove these ions. So during the softening process, some of the useful ions may be removed. So this is under industrial use. Coming to the environment, toxic substances and high populations of certain microorganisms can present a health hazard for non-drinking purpose, such as irrigation, swimming, fishing, rafting, boating, and industrial uses. These conditions may also affect wildlife which use the water for drinking or as a habitat. Coming to irrigation purpose, mainly for crop production, the irrigation, we need the water quality of certain, having certain parameters for irrigation purpose. So agricultural activity is the largest user of the fresh water. So, and it is also a major cause of degradation of surface and groundwater resource. Because due to this agricultural activities, soil erosion takes place. And also the chemical usage in the agricultural activities in the form of pesticides, insecticides, and these things, chemicals which are used in the agricultural activities, get into the surface and groundwater resources, increasing the contaminants in these water resources. And the general water quality parameters. Following is a list of indicators which is often measured to decide the quality of water. In that, first one we have alkalinity, color of water, pH, taste and odor. Then you have dissolved metals and salts like sodium chloride, potassium, calcium, manganese, magnesium, then microorganisms such as fecal coliform, bacteria, cryptosporidium, and Giardia lamblia, dissolved metals and metalloids like lead, mercury, arsenic, etc. Then dissolved organics like colored dissolved organic matter, dissolved organic carbon, then heavy metals. Then you have pharmaceutical byproducts. Then parameters, they depend upon the type of usage. That is various usage like for drinking purpose, industrial usage, irrigation, etc. So these are the list of indicators for water quality parameters. Then water quality, that is environmental indicators. So chemical, the various assessment are the chemical assessment, physical assessment, then biological assessment. That is under chemical assessment, you have dissolved oxygen, RDO, then nitrate, orthophosphates, chemical oxygen demand, COD, biochemical oxygen demand, POD, pesticides, then metals. Then physical assessment. Under physical assessment, we have pH, temperature, total suspended solids or TSS, turbidity, then total dissolved solids or TDS. Under biological assessment, biological monitoring metrics have been developed in many places, and one widely used measure is the presence and abundance of members of certain species of insects like mayfly, stonefly, and caddisfly. So like this, the three assessments done on the water quality to check the water quality, that is falling under environmental indicators. Then some important physicochemical parameters that is done to check the water quality or the, like these things come under physicochemical parameters. Like first one is pH, color, taste and odor, turbidity, TDS, total hardness, chlorides, sulfates, fluorides, nitrates, and calcium, heavy metals, dissolved oxygen, pesticides, detergents, and radiopesticides, detergents, and radionuclides. And the pH, if you check, the for drinking water, it should be around 6.5 to 8. So neutral pH means around 7. Acidic pH less than 7. Then coming to electrical conductivity, one of the water quality parameter. Electrical conductivity? It is the ability of the water to conduct electrical current. So the ability depends upon the concentration of the dissolved salts present in the water. And this parameter is used to find total dissolved solids present in the water. Unit is microsiemens per centimeter. Then you have the parameters like odor, color, and taste. So how will you classify the odor? Like you will categorize like very weak, weak, clear, strong, or very strong. Now when you check the color, you will be using, it is tested using colorimeter tubes, and color is expressed in Hess and standard unit. Taste, you can, if the water is of purest form, it is tasteless. And coming to turbidity, it is caused by presence of suspended materials, which ranges in size from colloidal to coarse dispersions. And it is measured by nephrometer or turbidity meter, and it is expressed in NTU. Nephrometric turbidity unit. So this turbidity is very, very essential parameter in the water treatment plant, water in checking the water quality. And dissolved oxygen, which indicates the amount of oxygen in the form of gas dissolved in water, that is solubility of atmospheric oxygen in fresh water, ranges from 14.6 milligrams per liter at 0 degree Celsius to about 7 milligrams per liter at 35 degree Celsius under 1 atmospheric pressure. So this dissolved oxygen is measured using DO meter or dissolved oxygen meter. Coming to BOD, that is biochemical oxygen demand, amount of dissolved oxygen demanded by bacteria during stabilization of the decomposable organic matter under aerobic condition. So BOD can be expressed as amount of oxygen consumed per liter of the water sample during 5 days of incubation at 20 degrees Celsius. And coming to nitrate, it is a water soluble molecule made up of nitrogen and oxygen. It is a natural constituent of plants. In natural form, water contains less than 1 milligram of nitrogen per liter, and higher levels of nitrate causes contamination. And what are the common sources of nitrate or fertilizers, animal waste, etc.? And maximum permissible limit is 10 ppm. Chlorides, that is mainly from dissolved salt deposits or discharge from effluents, etc. And the maximum limit of chloride in the water should be 250 ppm parts per million. And fluorides, fluorine containing compounds, fluorides, the main source, found naturally in lower concentration in drinking water and food. If it is fresh water, it is around 0.012-0.3 ppm. Ocean water contains 1.2 to 1.5. Permissible is 1 ppm. So more amount of fluoride means it causes disease like skeletal fluorosis. Then hardness represents total concentration of calcium and magnesium ions in parts per million. Hard water is generally not harmful to one's health, but it can pose serious problems in industrial settings where we require the soft water in industries. Coming to iron, which is naturally occurring, but it is not hazardous, that much hazardous, but the recommended limit is 0.3 milligrams per liter. Coming to heavy metals like arsenic, cadmium, chromium, copper, iron, manganese, mercury, nickel, silver, zinc, etc., it is present as minerals in soil and also artificially from man-made things. Some of these major contaminations are determined by atomic absorption spectrophotometer, polarography, or calorimetry. Then arsenic means, according to World Health Organization guidelines, it should be less than 0.05 milligrams per liter. And pesticides, it causes more harmful health effects. It is highly carcinogenic. Various pesticides are DDT, then BHC, parathion, endosulfan, etc. Then detergents, phenol, radionuclides, etc. It should be less than 0.5 milligrams per liter as per World Health Organization. Coming to halogenated chloro-organic compounds, main source due to high chlorination for disinfection. So this should be in lesser amount, and microbes, indicator potential, that is which causes various waterborne disease like bacteria. So my various microbes like bacteria, virus, pathogenic protozoa, etc. So these microbes, they cause various waterborne disease. This comes under one of the important water quality parameter. Then various water quality issues in India, that is water resources are highly exploited. There's over exploitation resulting in major water quality problems. And common issues of surface and groundwater are pathogenic, that is pollution, pathogenic pollution, salinity, toxicity, and other industrial pollutants. Coming to surface water, we have problems like eutrophication, oxygen depletion, ecological health of the water resource are highly affected. That is due to pollution in the water resources. Groundwater, major pollutants like fluoride, nitrate, arsenic, iron, and the last one, seawater intrusion also affect the groundwater. Coming to the last topic, need for water treatment. Water is one of the basic resource for the survival of life on the planet. Access to the water and sanitation and hygiene is a fundamental right of all people. Yet billions of people throughout the world, they are facing difficulty in getting the basic services like the water. So water treatment. So for this, we have to check the water resource. So we have to protect the, that is less usage, correct usage of the water without wasting the water. We have to save the water. And the water treatment, what are the various treatment process carried out for water is like physical treatment, chemical treatment, physicochemical treatment, and biological treatment. So by going for these treatment process, the various pollutants, contaminants found in the water can be either eliminated or it can be reduced according to the requirement of the water satisfying certain standards. The objective of this treatment process, water treatment process, is to obtain clean water for which we use the water. So we, for this purpose, we go for various treatment process, which varies as a function of the properties of the water which is being supplied for its final use. Water treatment is increasingly necessary due to drinking water shortages and due to the growing population. More the demand, the water demand also becomes also increases, and due to this we have to go for the treatment, that is treatment of the water for drinking purpose, and also we have to save the water to meet the water shortages. So in the planet, the total water reserve is only 2.5%. The two fresh water, in that only 0.4% is fit for human consumption. So we have to go for the treatment, the water treatment. Since the availability of water is also very less, that too highly polluted. For this, I'll stop. Thank you.